Here we are, central, beautiful central Victoria. We're about to enter the house of the inventor of the pattern drafter. Hello.
Hello.
Hi, Maria.
Hi, Nathan.
Can we come in?
Certainly can.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Wow. Look at all those BERNINAs. Okay, Maria, we have our first question. What brought you to the sewing industry?
Well, Nathan, I think I was born in the sewing industry. I've been sewing for a very long time. My mother and myself and siblings came out from Italy and she bought out our Singer sewing machine, treadle sewing machine, no electricity. So I was sewing from the time I was 10, mainly altering clothes that were hand-me-downs from my sisters. So they didn't fit me, so I started the love affair with sewing back then. And then my mother was happy to have me on the sewing machine doing everything from making clothes for the whole family to aprons, pillowcases and so forth. Continued the love in high school, did very well at high school with my sewing, and then went on to further my education and work in a bridal store where I made clothing. I did bridal couture sewing for many, many years, probably about 20 years or so, having my own business as well. Worked at TAFE for about 22 years, teaching pattern making and sewing. That was two classes at night and one day class. And then through that I developed the pattern drafter. So I've been sewing for my family, for myself, the people for many, many years, and just love it. Just love being in the industry. Love fabric, love machines. It's my happy place.
Another question, Maria. Why did you develop the pattern drafter?
Good question, Nathan. It was whilst I was working at TAFE. Teaching pattern making, and we were using a right angle ruler and a French curve.
I remember those days.
and we would have to take about 30 measurements to make up a block pattern. It was a 2-year course. It was very involved, and a lot of people would find it very difficult and perhaps quit before they finished. And that was really unfortunate. I was using my own system. It was just a cardboard cutout of my own system in my business, making bridal, because with bridal, they only tend to want one wedding dress, so you're forever making patterns and time's money. So the patterns I made were very quick, very easy. And one day the student said to me, what do I use in a way of pattern making? Because the system we were using and teaching at TAFE seemed very tedious. So I said to them that I combined the right angle rule and the French curve together, calculated all the measurements into quarter plus ease, and then used that system. So they then wanted to see it. So I brought along this cardboard cutout of what is now the pattern drafter, and they wanted one. And I said, well, you know, there's no book with it, there's no anything with it. And the other thing I found was that women who'd love to sew wouldn't sew for themselves because commercial patterns weren't quite right or too involved, and therefore they gave up on sewing. And I thought, well, I don't want the industry to die. I don't want sewing to be a dying art. So I thought I would develop the ruler, not knowing exactly what I was in for. I then began to search local manufacturers to help develop the pattern drafter to what it is today with the right plastic, the right print and so forth, the calculations that are on there, and also the instruction book, because, you know, it's all in my head, so I had to put it down in a book. And it took 2.5 years to develop it from start to finish. It was a very long, tedious process. Plus I had 3 children, single mum, I had 2 jobs, but I got there in the end, and I'm proud to say that it's 99% Australian made. owned and developed, of course, in here in Australia. So once it was developed and then manufactured, it was then a matter of marketing. So that was back in 2010. So it was a huge learning curve, something that I'm very proud of, but it means that anybody can use the ruler. It doesn't matter if you're a beginner or an advanced professional sewer, pattern maker, you can use it. And rather than take 30 measurements to draw your block pattern, you're only taking 7 measurements. So it's a very quick and easy process to be able to do your formula of measurements, not your size. That's only a manufacturer's interpretation of what their client is. So you're using your formula of measurements. So regardless of whether you're big, small, short, long, and so forth, it's your measurements, therefore the pattern's going to fit you first time. And from that block pattern, you can then develop anything from a pair of pajamas to a wedding dress, because everything starts as a block pattern.
Perfect. I also see behind you, is this the evolution of the pattern drafter books?
It is. So the first one is the one that was developed in 2010, and then an updated version in 2015. We now have the children's pattern drafter, which makes patterns for boys or girls from 6 months to 16 years.
Wow.
And then of course, then it goes to the adult version. And this is the latest addition to the family. This is going to be an ebook, and it's the second edition of the pattern drafter. It's a more technical book with many, many designs. So that's available now online through the website, thepatterndrafter.com.
Perfect. Now, can you show us how easy it is to use your ruler?
Certainly can.
So this is the ruler.
It is. So we use the front of the ruler to do the front of the dress, the back of the ruler to do the back of the dress. The back of the ruler makes your sleeve block, and the front of the ruler does your pants block. And to do your collar block, we just use the right angle of the ruler. So the measurements are all calculated for you. So for example, if your bust measurement is 100, you mark it at 100. We use the instruction book that gives you how to take your 7 measurements. And from those 7 measurements, you make your dress block. So I'm going to draw the front for you. And you always start by drawing a right angle. So drawing a right angle along the side and across the top. And the first thing we need to mark in is your waist length at A. So mark that as A. Your bust measurement at B. We also use the bust measurement at C. And then the 2 neckline markings along there and there. So that's your first step. And you'll notice that the markings are in alphabetical order from A to F. Now we bring the ruler down. So the top of the ruler lines up at B, and draw a horizontal line across at B and mark in the bust measurement at D. Now we're going to join some dots together, C, and the top neckline can get joined together, and that creates your shoulder. Turn the ruler upside down and you'll see the word neck curve. So you line it up at the 2 neckline markings and draw in the neck curve. Now the words always face you. If the word's not facing you, it's not positioned correctly. From there, I'm going to turn the ruler to the right and mark in the armhole at E. So I line up the bust measurement at E and correspond it with C and drawing the armhole, like so, and that's E. So we've done A, B, C, D, E. Now we're up to F. F is used for your waist and hips. So line up the bottom of the ruler at A, draw another horizontal line along the bottom, and mark in your waist measurement. And remember, this is your measurement. Anything from 60 centimetres to 138 centimetres. You can also increase and decrease, and the instruction book shows you how. from there, that's the waist measurement, I'm going to add 3 centimetres. I'm going to use my ruler to mark in an extra 3 centimetres, and that's for the waist start. So that's F. Now we're going to join F to D, like so. And I've just drawn to the waist. From A, which is your waistline, I'm going to come down 20 centimetres, and that's a standard measurement, and that's where your hip measurement will be placed. So we're using F again for the hips, placing the ruler at the 20 centimetre point, draw a horizontal line along the bottom, and this time mark in the hip measurement. To join the hip to the waist, we're going to use the hip curve. So line up the arrow of the hip curve at the hip line, correspond it with the waist, and draw in the hip curve. So now I've drawn to the hips using 5 measurements. The other 2 measurements that you've taken will be your bust distance and your bust length. This will pinpoint exactly where your darts will be placed. So to do that, you would have taken a bust distance measurement. This is your center front. So we're going to mark the bust distance at the shoulder, at the bust, the waist, and at the hip line, and then draw a reference line through each of these markings. So that was your bust distance. For your bust length, you measure down to what your bust length is, and then draw a reference line going through that bust length. So X marks the spot. From there, grab your pattern drafter again, and you see a bust circle. You line the bust circle at that X marks the spot point. And that gives you exactly 2 centimetre clearance for when you're drawing your dart. So your darts aren't meeting at a point, they're actually the right distance away. So now it's a matter of drawing your darts. We've added 3 centimetres for a waist dart. The reference line becomes the centre of the dart. So you mark 1.5 on either side. From the waist down, the dart is 12 centimetres. And then it's a matter of drawing the waist dart, remembering to go to the outer edge of that circle and down again. Now, one of the great features with drawing up your pattern, not only is it done in your formula of measurements plus ease, it also has your bust dart built in. So back in the day, in the TAFE days, we would have to cut the waist, drop it 2 centimetres, raise the armhole 1 centimetre to make an allowance for the dart, the bust dart. This is already built in, so it's just a matter of marking 1.5 on either side of that reference line and then drawing your dart in. So when it comes time to drawing the back of the dart, the back of the pattern, sorry, it'll be 3 centimetres shorter. So when you close that dart, it will correspond. At this point, you put in your grain line, you smooth out any pointy edges, and you cut it out and you try it on. So when you do cut it out, you have the front on a fold. You add seam allowance, because no block pattern has any seam allowance, so you can add 1 or 1.5 centimetre seam allowance. You don't add any seam allowance at the armhole or the neckline, because we need to see where the neckline and the armhole sits, and you add seam allowance to the shoulder, and that's your block pattern that you will try on front and back. Once it's tried on, that's when you will do any alterations for adjustments for a full bust adjustment or a sway back adjustment.
Wow, so that was 6 minutes. That's incredible. So can we see your toile?
You certainly can.
Perfect. All right, Maria, what are we looking at here?
So once you've made your block pattern, you need to try it on for the first time. So this is what was drawn previously. And you sew up your darts, try it on, and this is the chance that you get to cut away armholes and necklines further if you need to do a full bust adjustment or a sway back. So once that's fitted and any changes that you make on the calico, you would then do on your pattern, and then the pattern is yours to work with. It's ready to go. So if we're saying this is ready to go, this is our pattern and this is what we want to make. This is a Denise Burkett fabric,
beautiful
Australian made fabric. So if I wanted to change my block, and you can wear your block exactly as it is, you can add a collar to it or have it open, and that's your lapels. You can make a little Chanel jacket, that is perfect as a pattern on its own. To change it, and we're going to just change it a little bit, we're going to follow that neckline. It's as simple as drawing in your neckline. Like so. And remember, you're only using half the front, half the back. And we're leaving the sleeve the way it is. You notice that there's a seam at the front, so you would then add a seam to the front of your pattern. So you'd have the back on the fold and the front as an opening. Bust darts are left in, sewn in, but we don't have any waist darts on this outfit. We've got a looser fit, so all you need to do is not sew your darts in. So you can just remove the dart and you get a looser fit automatically. So that gives you a bit more room. You can also straighten the side seams out if you want extra room, or you're making something like a wind cheater or a shirt. So that's leaving that open and following that. The back on this outfit, we've got the darts sewn in, so we get a nice fit at the back, and you would do the same with your pattern. You would have that on the fold and you would sew your darts in and cut away the neckline further. So you don't have to have an elaborate design, you can keep it simple. To me, it's all about the fit. If it fits well, it looks good, it gives you confidence. And you can make the same pattern out in various fabrics and textures and colours and designs. You can add a sleeve to it. You can make it a summer, winter, spring, whatever you wish to do. It's as simple as that.
Just so easy. That's fantastic.
It is. And as I said, it's all about the fit, and it starts with the pattern. If the pattern fits, then you're on a winner. You can't go wrong.
Perfect. So Maria, on the way in, we noticed quite a few Berninas on your table. What do you like the most about your 475?
Well, Nathan, this is my Bernina family, I call it. So I use each and every one of the machines. I just love it. I just love the fact that I can sit down and set up. I know it's going to work. I particularly love the 475. The knee lift is amazing. Free hands. The width of the foot is just right for me, especially for doing curves and intricate work. And the screen. The screen is so easy to operate. It's very user friendly. And you've got a speed as well. So of course I like it on fast all the time. But there's times when I do have it on slow when I'm working with very intricate fabrics and designs. So what's not to love about the Bernina?
Fantastic. Thank you for sharing that with us. Now, one last thing before I go, Maria. Can you please talk a little bit more about the children's pattern drafter?
Absolutely, Nathan. So the children's pattern drafter was developed in 2017, and it's the same sort of system as the adult one, but it is a lot easier to use. So this will have 6 measurements instead of the 7, because we don't deal with busts when it comes to bust darts and waist darts when it comes to children. It'll do a child, either a boy or girl, from 6 months through to 16 years. And then from that point, it then goes to the adult ruler. And there is a 10 centimetre variable, so it crosses over with the adult ruler. In case you get a larger child, it still can cater for them as well. Obviously, it comes with an instruction book. Very easy to use, especially for a beginner, for a new mum or a grandparent. So very easy to follow, and it comes with a design section, and that shows everything from romper suits, boys' pants, pajamas, vests and so forth, dressing gowns, windcheaters, hoods, jackets and dresses. And we will soon also have, along with the dress online workshop and the pants online workshop, we will also have a children's online workshop as well.
That's perfect. And what was the website again?
The website is drafttstudio.com.
Perfect. Thank you.
Bernina, made to create.